Okay, so the subject of the show, Tu Bishvat. Rabotai, the Gemara tell us in Masechet Rosh Hashanah, page 2, folio 1, that the Gemara tell us that the day of Tu Bishvat, that means the 15th of Shvat, Rosh Hashanah La'ilan. Remember, in singly. Okay, we spoke about it before, I don't want to repeat it. But why does it say Rosh Hashanah La'ilan? We explain. I explained it briefly. Why singly and not in plural? Because many people say that it's the time that we judge, the tree get judged, the fruit of the tree get judged. And there is a symbol between the sin of Adam HaRishon to Tu Bishvat, that Adam HaRishon, actually the fruit that he sinned, that he eat from, was Etrog. And we should ask for a pure and a good, nice-looking Etrog for Sukkot, that we can celebrate. So that's why he's in singly. But let's move on and we'll see. We see there that there is a machloket between Bet Shammai and Bet Hillel. Bet Shammai say that, a matter of fact, that Tu Bishvat, the day that Rosh Hashanah, that means the New Year's for the Ilanot, for the trees, should be on Aleph Bishvat, the first of Shvat. Bet Shammai say, no, on the 15th of Shvat. And we know the halacha is like Bet Shammai, that's what we celebrate. Briefly, why? Because Hazal tell us why we paskin always lack Bet Shammai. Because Bet Shammai was humble. There was more humble. Bet Hillel. Sorry. We paskin like Bet Hillel. Thank you, Norman. Why do we paskin like Bet Hillel always? Because Bet Hillel was much more humble. What does it mean, Bet Hillel? According to Hillel. Bet Hillel, that was his yeshiva. That's where he taught. Okay. But with that, what the Gemara say. Now let's move to the oral Torah. The Torah tell us in Sefer Dvarim, chapter 20, verse 19, the Torah tell us something very interesting. Ve'adam hu etz hasadeh. The Torah compare a man to the tree in the field. How can we compare a man to a tree? Can you compare a man to a tree? Hazal come and tell us, yes, definitely. And now, Be'ezrat Hashem, we're going to show the comparison of a man to a tree. We're going to do what the Torah asks us to do, Torah Shebe'al Peh and Torah Shebechtav. So the first thing we know, that it's necessary for a tree to connect it to the ground, nachon? Without soil, the tree can't survive. I'm talking about tree, not about little veggies that today they're growing like they used to grow in Gush Katif on top of stone. I'm talking about a proper tree that needs its roots to grow into the ground. How much so? Hazal tell us that the same like a tree, it's very necessary for him to be connected to the ground, a Jewish man obligated to be connected to his Torah. Sorry? To Torah. Okay? What does it mean? We'll go just now and we see what does it mean to be connected to the Torah. We're talking about the spirituality. We'll get to it now. The Torah come and tell us another comparison. The same like a man need water to survive, a tree need water. Without water, a tree will die. You all agree? There is one that disputed. No, Baruch Hashem. So the Torah tell us that he need water. On a physical life, we all know each one of us need water. But Hazal come and tell us that each one of us, not only that he need water, that they compare the Torah to water. We all know that the Torah is like a water for a human being. That means for a Jewish man, a person that lives without Torah, the spirituality, that means that the spiritual soul is actually dying. It doesn't have any spirituality, the soul is dying. So that means that he needs Torah, because Torah, Hazal compare it to water. The third one, the same that the sapling need a support. When you plant a new tree, you call it sapling, am I right? Needed support. Need a piece of stick to make sure that it will grow up straight. A human being need also support when he grow up. He need a Talmid Chacham, he need a teacher to teach him the Torah, to teach him how, once that he have the Torah, how to behave. What it mean how to behave? How to do Ma'asim Tovim. So, another comparison we see from a human being to a tree. The fourth comparison that I'm going to bring, the same like a tree grow up to heaven all the time. All the time is facing up to the heaven, doesn't grow down. That's our job in life. To grow up with Yirat Shamayim, with the fear of heaven. To have Yirat Shamayim, a fear of heaven. Always to look up and to understand that the Almighty above us. So how much we're learning from the tree, Rabota? Let's move for the third comparison. What is the final thing that we expect from a tree? Fruit. Nahon, that's the final thing. The same like a tree bring fruit, that's how a human being should bring fruit. What fruit? Hazal tell us that in the end, after you learn Torah, after you done Ma'asim Tovim, it's not enough. You should be like the fruit that people eat from it, people benefit from it, people enjoy. It's once that you know Torah, start spread it, that people will enjoy from it, people will eat the Torah that you've given them. Torah Haimi, it's alive. That means that by that you study Torah is not enough. You have another obligation. What's the other obligation? Lilmod. To learn and to teach. That's what we say every day. That the chokhmah is that we're learning from the tree, like same like other people benefit from the fruit. That other human being, other Jewish people should benefit from us. I would like to move one step now forward and to look what's happening in the fruit. We know that we have a mitzvah on Tu Bishvat, to eat the fruit and to say a blessing. Nahon, everyone agreed? Is one that doesn't agree? Why is it so important? Why is it so important that we should say brachot and we should eat in Tu Bishvat? Why? Because it's the new year for the tree. Amas, eat fruit, especially fruit. She'eretz Yisrael nishtabha b'hem. That means that the land of Israel got blessed with those special fruit. What's so special about it? So Hazal tell us, on a simple level, by that we're blessing HaKadosh Baruch Hu and we're eating from the fruit, we actually doing not only praising HaKadosh Baruch Hu, we're making him happy. We're making a big praise. But now I'm going to move on to what I said at the beginning of the show. We're going to link it to what Chachmei HaKabbalah say. How come by eating fruit and saying blessing, we can reach to a higher spiritual level? So Chachmei HaKabbalah, the mystical rabbi, teach us something very important. They tell us, when we eat a fruit and we say a brocha, you know what we're doing? Anyone have any idea? No, help me. Sorry, say. Positivity to the world, one. What else? I'm making it spiritual. Oh, that's what I wanted to reach. Now, how do we make it spiritual? Just the brocha. No? What did you say? Sorry, I didn't hear.
Eating,
obviously eating. So by saying the brocha and eating, we're rectifying the fruit. But not only the fruit that we're rectifying, Rabotai, listen to that, what Hazal tell us. That there is certain fruit that there is special soul that been reincarnate on that. And there is special soul that be reincarnate on those fruit. That's how we can actually help them. How do you help them? By saying a brocha, a proper brocha, that you know what you're saying, that means that you have to understand. It means brachot tzrichot kavana. We learn that, Maran tell us, what it means tzrichot kavana. When you say a brocha, you have to understand what you're saying. You have to understand the meaning. You follow? Everyone understand that? So how do we rectify the soul that there is inside? By that, what we say in the proper bracha, about, let's say, let's take example, Bore Priyayet, a fruit that comes from the tree. We say Bore Priyayet, and we sing the full brocha, and then we taking that fruit and we're eating from it, we rectify what was inside. In Lashon, the Mekubalim, they call it Tikkun Neshamot. What it means, Tikkun Neshamot? By that you sing the brocha, you help, Menachem, that's what you say, to uplift the physicality to a spirituality. Now, it's not only the reincarnation that come in those fruit, certain fruit that been, certain human being soul that been reincarnated in a fruit, it's also from Gezel. Everyone understand the word Gezel? No. You don't know what Gezel? Stealing. Stealing. Robbing. Not only that, also Ma'asrot. That if person didn't done Ma'asrot, Hazal tell us, by that you're saying the brocha and the correct brocha, you rectify. Now we're going to reach how does it work. So how does it work really? So we say that there is four different worlds. Olamot Abia. Abia, what is Abia? Atzilut, Bria, Yetzira, Asiya. That's Abia. This means that there is the world of nobility. Everyone with me? Everyone understand? Menachem, no. Okay. That's how they call it. I don't know how you say it in English. I really not. Olam HaBria, that's the creation. The world of creation. Yetzira, that's the world of creativity. Olam Asiya, it's the Olam of action. The world of action. Rabbi Chaim Vital. Rabbi Chaim Vital, that's the Maharhu, the famous Maharhu, that he was the famous student of Ari HaKadosh. And he wrote the book, Etz HaChaim, that's all Kabbalah, because Ari HaKadosh only permit him to write it. He didn't allow none of his other students. He born, Rabbi Chaim Vital, born in Yerushalayim 474 years ago. And he explained it like this. How do we see in a fruit, which fruit belong to which world? So we're going to start from Olama Asiya. That means from the world of action and we go up. Rabbi Chaim Vital explained that the world of action, he compared it to the fruit, listen to that, that we eat the inside of it, the inside of the fruit, and the exterior of the fruit, we throw it away. For example, for us just to understand, you know, if you look at the banana, the exterior we peel, and we throw it away. You agree with me? But the inside of the banana we do eat. Nahon? That's the same with orange. You agree with me? Pomegranate. And exterior. So he said, that's those kind of a fruit symbol the world of action. When it's come to the world of creativity, Olama Yetzira, he said, take those fruit that we eat, the exterior of them, and the interior of them, what there is interior, we throw away. For example, a date. We eat the dates outside, the pips inside, we throw away. Not only that, we do it with olive. Nachon, you agree with me? Yes. We do it also with the orange. Nachon? There's many more fruit. So Rabbi Chaim Vital compared those kind of a fruit to Olam HaYetzirah, creativity, the world of creativity. Now we're moving to one higher level, Olam HaBriyah, the creation, the world of a creation. He said, the fruit that we eat them complete, without throwing anything. For example, figs, you know? Obviously, you have to open, you have to make sure that those figs clean from any worms. So it's come and tell you, this kind of a fruit that you eat it completely, figs, carrots, strawberries, nachon, you don't throw nothing. Those are fruit that he compared to the world of, no, what did I say? Creation, Olam HaBriyah. So now you're all going to jump on me and say, wait, we're missing one world. The world of nobility. Where is the world of nobility? Nachon? Sorry?
Nobility.
Nobility. Where is that world come? That's the brocha that we say over the fruit. Do you understand? So we go in step with the fruit. But the highest world, Olam HaAtzilut, is the blessing that we say on the fruit. Now we understand how we compare it. Now, last year, I say, okay, that's beautiful. But how come that we have to celebrate Tu Bishvat Dafka? Why did HaKadosh Baruch Hu decide to celebrate Tu Bishvat? That, the new years for the tree, when the season change, you know, in Israel now, supposed to be now a change of season. Shouldn't be actually winter. Now it should be between spring and winter. It's supposed to be more spring. So how come now? So Hazal actually give us few opinion about it. Hazal in the Gemara, Masechet Rosh Hashanah, page 43, folio 2. That means Mem Gimel Amud Bet. Gemara explained that the main reason that Hazal tell us Dafka now supposed to be Tu Bishvat, because most of the rain in Eretz Israel, because it's winter there in the northern hemisphere, it's already finished. The ground fully absorbed of rain, it's fully moisturized. And there is something very important that we start seeing the buds growing. So Hazal tell us that when we see such a miracle like this, we have to celebrate Rosh Hashanah. That means that now that we see that most of the ground full of moisture and the tree now starting to come alive again, while we're seeing the little buds, that's good enough to celebrate the new year for the fruit, for the trees. And the final question, and with that I'm going to conclude. If that's the case, we all know the minhagim that we have on Tu Bishvat. We're not allowed to say Tahanun. Everyone agree with me?
Yes.
Baruch Hashem. Not only that, we're not allowed to show any kind of mourning on Tu Bishvat. Why is that? What difference does it make to me? What difference does it make to me if the tree been judged or not been judged dafka today? Why should it be a day of simcha for us as a human being? So Hazal explains something very interesting. Hazal said, I'm going to bring two reasons. And as I mentioned before, Hazal compares us to a tree. Nachon? Ki Adam mo'etz ha'sadeh, a man is like a tree in a field, in an orchard, in a vineyard, whatever you want to call it. Hazal tell us something very interesting. Hazal tell us, by that we see that during the winter season, if we look at a tree, what's happening? He go to sleep, nachon? Doesn't bring fruit, there is no flower. You agree with me, Kolem? Nachon? Baruch Hashem. And suddenly, in a higher season, that we think that this tree is dead, what did we see? A miracle. What's happening? New life coming. We start seeing the buds coming. To tell us that there is a circle on life. HaKadosh Baruch Hu show us that He make miracle every minute. HaKadosh Baruch Hu here bring us to understand that the circle of life doesn't end after the body disappears. There's new life all the time. Not only that, to give us a hope when things is difficult. After every downhill, there is uphill. Nahon? So to tell us, the same like the fruit, suddenly go to sleep, the tree, all the leaves fall down. Next thing we start seeing the buds, we see new life. And Hazal tell us, by that we see that miracle, that we see that HaKadosh Baruch Hu doing miracle in nature, it's good enough for us to celebrate and to be happy. To understand that HaKadosh Baruch Hu make miracle every moment of the day with us. And Be'ezrat Hashem, that we take it on ourselves, to see the miracle that HaKadosh Baruch Hu doing with us and think positively, and we'll see only miracle and only, please God, smachot. And Be'ezrat Hashem, I blessed all of you that we should see only from now on happiness and prosperity. Amen. Ken yei ratzon.